All right, now let's go back to the columns at the top of your order screen. We've talked about service. Order is the actual written order. Start-stop time indicates the time the order was written or should start. And stop time is when the order will drop off the system. For many orders, you will not see a stop time as they should be continued throughout your patient's admission. Looking at the start time is one way to check for new orders. The provider is the person who wrote the order. Nurse, clerk, chart are columns that will contain the initials of the person who read and acknowledged the order by signing it. Orders with a blank box are likely new as no one has signed them. As students, you will not be able to verify and sign orders, but you should call your preceptor's attention to any new orders that need to be signed and acted on. The status column indicates whether the order is active, pending, or discontinued. We have talked about these statuses before. The location is where the order will be carried out. This will likely say the inpatient location and provider team, but you may see orders that were previously written by an outpatient provider that have not yet been acted on or completed by the system. Likely, these will not pertain to something you need to follow up on while your patient is hospitalized. We talked about this briefly before, but I'd like to remind you about flagged orders. Flagged orders are orders surrounded by a red border and require special attention. Any provider or staff member can flag an order that is confusing, need special attention, or follow-up. Usually you will see DNR orders flagged because it is an important order that needs to be noticed and requires follow-up by a physician to reorder it when it expires.